Fifth dimension, beyond that which is known to man. It is a dimension as vast as space and as timeless as infinity. It is the middle ground between light and shadow, between science and superstition, and it lies between the pit of man's fears and the summit of his knowledge. This is the dimension of imagination. It is an area which we call the Twilight Zone.
I've been a participant in some of the most insidious lies and witness to deeds that no crazed man can imagine. I spent years watching you from my lofty position to know that you were the one I could trust.
And why did you lie to me?
There still exists some secrets which should remain secret. Truths that people are just not ready to know.
Who are you to decide that?
The world's reaction to such knowledge would be far too dangerous.
Dangerous? You mean in the sense of outrage? Like the reaction to the Kennedy assassination, or MIAs, or radiation experiments on terminal patients, Watergate, Iran-Contra, Roswell, the Tuskegee experiments. Where will it end?
You want answers?
I think I'm entitled.
You want answers?
I want the truth!
You can't handle the truth! Get up!
Off what? You'll kill me?
Always remember, dissension's the greatest form of patriotism.
The very word secrecy is repugnant in a free and open society. And we are, as a people, inherently and historically opposed to secret societies.
We have before us the opportunity to forge a new world order.
Yes, we can. As you say.
Let us never tolerate outrageous conspiracy theories.
A lie is most convincingly hidden between two truths.
Well, I guess it won't end.
No! I don't have time for this. This is about saving the future of humanity.
We know things are bad, worse than bad. We know the air is unfit to breathe and our food is unfit to eat.
I don't want you to protest. I don't want you to write to your congressman because I wouldn't know what to tell you to write. I don't know what to do about the depression and the inflation and the crime in the street. All I know is that first, you've got to get mad.
The line must be drawn here. This far, no farther.
I want you to get up right now. Go to your windows, open them, and stick your head out and yell, I'm a human being. My life has value, and I'm not going to take this anymore.
You shall not!
We'll be right back. Some viewers may find the following video disturbing. Viewer discretion is advised.
Thank you. They're all covered with filthy germs, aren't they, Smithers?
Why, what do you mean, sir?
Freemasons run the country!
Ew!
Throughout Crowley's years as a magus and his many, many magical experiments, he often attempted to contact intelligences of the non-human variety through the uttering of barbarous names, incantations, and the regurgitation of ancient inscriptions and veiled verses. Crowley called forward all manner of spirits, demons, and invisible masters from which he sought counsel. One particular entity, or at least icon, of the Crowleyan pantheon that draws an intense amount of interest is the character known as Lamb. Around 1917, in New York, Crowley drew the image of this praetor human intelligence after performing a ritual now known as Alamantra, working. During this experiment, a discarnate entity urged Crowley to find the egg, and it seems at some point Crowley experienced contact with this large-headed entity we have come to know as Lamb. For Crowley, sex was treated as a sacrament, with the consumption of sexual fluids interpreted as a Eucharist. This was often manifested as the cakes of light, a biscuit containing either menstrual blood or a mixture of semen and vaginal fluids. The Gnostic Mass is the central religious ceremony within Thelma.
Thank you.
Throughout Crowley's years as a magus and his many, many magical experiments, he often attempted to contact intelligences of the non-human variety through the uttering of barbarous names, incantations, and the regurgitation of ancient inscriptions and veiled verses. Crowley called forward all manner of spirits, demons, and invisible masters from which he sought counsel. One particular entity, or at least icon, of the Crowleyan pantheon that draws an intense amount of interest is the character known as Lamb. Around 1917 in New York, Crowley drew the image of this praetor human intelligence after performing a ritual now known as Alamantra, working. During this experiment, a discarnate entity urged Crowley to find the egg, and it seems at some point Crowley experienced contact with this large-headed entity we have come to know as Lamb. For Crowley, sex was treated as a sacrament, with the consumption of sexual fluids interpreted as a Eucharist. This was often manifested as the cakes of light, a biscuit containing either menstrual blood or a mixture of semen and vaginal fluids. The Gnostic Mass is the central religious ceremony within Thelma. known as Alamantra, working. During this experiment, a discarnate entity urged Crowley to find the egg.
Same sideshow shut down, nowhere to hang. Everybody moved away, then times changed. 9/11 made the price on the pies raise. They still getting high anyways. So I'm really fly, sitting up on trees. Always buy, nigga, never front shit to me. X around, ain't front by my history. I've been around since Ryder sung Misery. Running through a key, doing murder in the streets. Got a cut for me if you really wanna eat. That's not a threat, I'm just saying, boy, I got it cheap. Out of state, star quarterback, going deep.
Welcome back. Overnight, police in Oakland arresting a man they say attacked and killed two young women who were just waiting for a BART train. Happened Sunday night. Police say 27-year-old John Cowell approached 18-year-old Nia Wilson and her older sister and attacked them, seemingly unprovoked. Nia didn't survive. The BART police chief called it the most vicious attack he has ever seen.
Very glad that in less than 24 hours we were able to get the subject into custody. Obviously very dangerous, not only in the BART system, but throughout all the communities here in the Bay Area.
Last night, police arrested Kyle after a BART commuter spotted him on a train. They're still trying to figure out the motive behind the attack.
11, code 33, MacArthur. We get reports of subject with a knife at MacArthur on the platform.
10-4, all units, code 33 for MacArthur. 11, do we know which platform?
Negative.
You're free, and freedom is beautiful. And, it'll take time to restore chaos and order, but we're order out of chaos, but we will.
33 MacArthur, we get reports of subject with a knife at MacArthur on the platform.
10-4, all units, code 33 for MacArthur.
MacArthur. We get reports of subject with a knife at MacArthur on the platform.
10-4, all units, code 33 for MacArthur.
Now, here comes the source. Now, you have to be very observant now. The true name of Satan, the Kabbalists say, is Yahweh. Reverse. For Satan is not a black god, but a negation of God. For initiates, this is not a person, but a force. You have heard of movies that say, the force be with you? Okay. Please note, I'll read this again. To the Kabbalists, they say, Yahweh, reverse. Okay. So that's their god. They turn everything upside down. To the outside world, they say, Yahweh. To the inner world, it means what? Satan. So they can preach in the name of Jesus Christ the most eloquent sermons, and you wouldn't know that they're preaching about Lucifer. You wouldn't know. Now, the name of Yahweh reversed. Now, I was in Israel the other day, and I was on the track of something very important, and I took many photographs. And a man came up to me and he flashed something at me. Very strange. There was another evangelist right next to me. He flashed something and he says, look, Allah is your God upside down. And he walked away. And I thought he was nuts. I read the statement. I went to a Hebrew scholar. And I said, will you check this out for me? And he battled and he battled and he battled and he battled. When the Mason learns that the key to the worry on the block is the proper application of the dynamic dynamo of living power, he has learned the mastery of his craft. The seething energy of Lucifer are in his hands. Manly pommel, high Masonic form. The devil is now called darkness by the church, whereas in the Bible he's called the Son of God, Lucifer, son of the morning. One quote after the other. And here's the other quote, Blavatsky, Secret Doctrine. Jehovah, esoterically, is also the serpent or dragon. I'm not saying it. The highest source in occultism is saying it. They tempted Eve, and the dragon is an old glyph for astral light, which is wisdom in chaos. So, esoterists turn everything upside down. Here she writes in Secret Doctrine, the great serpent of the Garden of Eden and the Lord God are identical. They're Luciferians, you see. And so are Jehovah and Cain, one, the Cain who is referred to in theology as the murderer and the liar. So the God of the Bible is the murderer and the liar, and the serpent is exalted. That's secret esoteric teaching, only known to the adepts. Here, another quote from Secret Doctrine. The appellation Satan in Hebrew, Satan, an adversary. To be adverse belongs by right to the first and cruelest adversary of all the other gods, Jehovah. Not to the serpent who spoke only words of sympathy and wisdom. And it is the worst, even in the dogma, the adversary of man. See? So the bad guy is Jesus. The good guy is Satan. Therefore, Jehovah was called by the Gnostics the creator of and one with Ophiomorphos, the serpent, Satan. They turn it upside down. I'm not making this up. He's known as the supreme architect of the universe. This is all quotes. Who has promised that we shall never, never die. This is a Masonic source which blows them out of the water. What do they call their deity? The supreme architect of the universe. But he's the one who said you will never, never die. Which one said that? The serpent said it. So the poor Masons in the lower ranks don't know these things. Here's another one from Morals and Dogma. Just to make sure that you see that I'm not making this up. The deity of the Old Testament is everywhere represented as the direct author of evil. I hereby promise to Lucifer, my soul, the secret teaching of all ages, mainly Palmer Hall. And who is then allowed to know the truth about Masonry? Well, we must create a super right which remains unknown. Only some may know these things and others not. Now, when you become a Shriner, that means when you have reached the 32nd degree of Freemasonry, you qualify after 6 months to become a Shriner. Now, if you were a Christian, you swore allegiance on the Bible. But when you become a Shriner, you swear allegiance to Allah. With the Quran on the altar, we sealed our solemn oath in the name of Allah, the God of Arab, Muslim, Mohammedan, the God of our fathers. Wow, that's interesting. The Masla, here is one of their phases. Now we understand something. The one is a front organization for a front organization, but the one who receives worship is Rome, not Islam. Islam is subservient to Rome without anyone knowing it. So let's repeat this one. The true name of Satan, the Kabbalists say, is Yahweh reversed. And here it is. There's the name of God, Yahweh, as it is in Hebrew. If you carefully reverse it, each one, and turn it upside down, in reverse writing you have that. Upside down you have that. You press it together, you have that. And that spells Allah in Arabic. Wow. That's fascinating stuff. So that man who came to me there and flashed this at me and disappeared, was he right?
I first met Tim Berners-Lee in the mid-1980s. Then later, he wrote this, his proposal and so on. I saw the proposal. And I think the second time around, or maybe the third time around, a proposal actually was looked at, and he was in a position to ask for a computer that he wanted to prototype this on. And I also will never forget the day when about 2 or 3 months later, I think this was ordered in May of 1990, Tim rushed in my office and said, "Ben, Ben, it's arrived, come and look." And I went in his office and I saw this sexy black cube and he was just setting it up. And it was the easiest machine to set up that I'd ever seen.
Saturn is the key in so many ways to what is happening. Saturn, Kronos, Satan, Black Sun, Dark Lord, they're all the same thing, the expression of this force. And here you have Moloch, who they worship at Bohemian Grove, and he is a god of Saturn, this recurring theme. They also represent Moloch as a bull, as I said earlier, and so you have that as the symbol of Wall Street. And the golden calf in the Bible is Moloch, Saturn. The Greeks talked about Saturn used to eat his own children.
forge for ourselves and for future generations a new world order. A world where the rule of law, not the law of the jungle, governs the conduct of nations. When we are successful, and we will be, we have a real chance at this new world order.
Satan, as it also became known, which is you find with so many politicians. And Pat Robertson, this so-called Christian evangelist, yeah, okay. And talking of horns and horned gods, in astrology, Saturn is connected to Capricorn. And so one of the Saturn symbols is the goat. This again is the great Freemasonic historian Manly P. Hall, who said Pan, the goat god, was a composite creature, the upper part, with the exception of his horns, being human, and the lower part in the form of a goat. The god himself is a symbol of Saturn, because this planet is enthroned in Capricorn, whose emblem is a goat. That is what that is. Baphomet, worshipped by Satanists. It's a symbol of Saturn. And I'm going somewhere with this, because I'm going why they're focused on Saturn. So, you have Baphomet, you have Beyonce, the wife of Jay-Z, with this big Baphomet ring, which is performing. You have Baphomet-dressed Lady Gaga, Baphomet-dressed Madonna, and you have Baroness Philippine de Rothschild from the wineries in France with a massive Baphomet necklace. And this is from the front cover of the Saturn myth, with the symbolism described of these lights that went off from Saturn at certain points, with the four main ones there. And there it is symbolized on one of these ancient tablets. And in St. Peter's Square, that is a mirror of the way that Saturn symbol looks. And there it is on the thing that he has his biscuit in, there, where he's doing his stuff.
Thank you.
numerologically, digitally, Saturn is number 8. And this has led to symbolism of Saturn in terms of the spider. Thus, you have in Madonna's Super Bowl performance, the winged disc symbolized with a spider in the center. Now, this is fascinating. This is called the magic square of Saturn. And it's also, not by coincidence, the magic square of Freemasonry. And it's magic because of this reason. If you go that way, that way, that way, that way, or that way, or that way, all the numbers in the three blocks in line add up to 15. And in numerology, you keep adding numbers until they become a single number. And so 15 in numerological terms is 6. So 666, 666 in all directions. And the black and white squares, for reasons I'll have to go into in detail in a book, because you know, so much to get through today, also relates to Saturn. And so you have them in Freemasonic temples, black and white squares, and you have them in the major cathedrals, like Westminster Abbey and stuff, because of this connection I'm talking about. Now, this is called the sigil of Saturn. And they get this symbol by drawing in the magic square of Saturn from 1 to 2, and then to 3, from 4 to 5 to 6, etc. That's how they get it. Now you turn that straight up, and that's what that is. It's the sigil of Saturn. And this is a major symbol of Saturn going way back, the six-pointed star. It just so happens to be the very symbol from which we get the name Rothschild, one of the major families in this network. Because they used to be called Bauer, they lived in Frankfurt in Germany. But they had this red six-pointed star hexagram on the front of their house, and they changed their name to from Bauer to Red Shield in German, Rothschild, red sign or red shield, Rothschild. So they're named after this very symbol. And it was they that created Israel, not on behalf of Jewish people, on behalf of their bloody agenda that treats Jewish people with as much disdain as any of the rest of us. And so you have their symbol on the flag of Israel. They use the six-pointed star so much in law enforcement. This is on a public building in Toronto, right in the center of the six-pointed star. There's the horned god. There's the sheriff and a medal. There is the six-pointed star representing Saturn on an ancient clay depiction. And there it is on Credo Mutwa's 500 to 1,000-year-old Zulu hand symbol. If you do that on the dollar bill, you get the six-pointed star, and those letters make an anagram of Mason, interestingly. Inside the Great Mother Lodge of Freemasonry in Great Queen Street, London, there is the Twin Towers, symbolic of the crescent, and there is Saturn again, the six-pointed star. Now, of course, the Roman Church and Christianity, that is anti-Freemasonry and anti-secret societies because they're naughty, but it's on his bloody fish hat, look, right? They're everywhere because the same force is in control. Here you go, I have a bit more Madonna, there you go. And on the Great Seal of the United States, those 13 stars make up a six-pointed star, not by accident. And therefore, again, we keep coming back to this, all these different areas of society are in the end focused on one thing. Satanism is Saturnism. This is Fritz Springmeier, a long-time researcher into this and symbolism, etc., and Satanism. Saturn is an important key to understanding the long heritage this conspiracy has back to antiquity. The city of Rome was originally known as the Saturnia, or City of Saturn. The Roman Catholic Church retains much of Saturn worship in its ritual. Saturn also relates to Lucifer. In various occult dictionaries, Saturn is associated with evil. And this is the remains of the Temple of Saturn in Rome. And just next to this is this place called Capitoline Hill now, but before that called Mons Saturnus, the Hill of Saturn. And this is a very symbolically important place to the bloodlines. And this whole thing about the skull and bones, Capitoline Hill comes from caput, meaning dead, because they were supposed to have found a human skull there, and they called it caput, Capitoline Hill. That's why we say caput when something's dead. And you have the theme in Christianity of Golgotha and Calvary, the place of the skull, hill of the skull. And Capitoline Hill became Capitol Hill when the bloodlines moved in on America. Now, in the North Pole, the northern pole of Saturn, is a permanent storm which takes the form of a hexagon. And this has been found by the Cassini spacecraft, and I think the Voyager one before that in the early 80s. And the hexagon also is an expression of the hexagram, or of the six-pointed star. Because all these different symbols that I'm going to talk about now are different expressions of the same frequency state. So you look at this crop circle from England this year, and it is a hexagon. But a hexagon is a flattened out cube. So when you look at it from another angle, it's a cube. Well, it just so happens that an ancient symbol of Saturn is the cube, especially the black cube. When the Cassini spacecraft arrived at Saturn in 2004, found many things that was unexplainable. You know, things like the hexagon North Pole storm and stuff like that. But they also found extraordinarily powerful sound coming from Saturn. This is part of what they recorded. Nice, man. And I got sent this by a sound engineer. Works in sound engineering for a living, and it's one of the rings of Saturn, and he said, I see that every day. That's bloody sound. They're sound waves. And this is in cymatics. This is a six-pointed star. And of course we have the hexagon going round and round and round at Saturn's north pole. This is a standing wave created by sound. Rings. This is at the south pole of Saturn, and it's a permanent ice storm. This is a standing wave created by sound. And these are symbols created by sound, like cymatics. And a certain frequency created this perfect six-pointed star with the hexagon in the middle and the hexagon there. Therefore, the sound creates the frequency, creates the symbol, and in the same way, the symbol represents the sound and the frequency. The symbols are just holographic representations of vibrational waveform states. I would suggest in these symbols cases, representatives of the sound frequency coming off Saturn. Same with all these symbols and numerological manipulations. The sound and the symbol are different expressions of the same thing. Thus, if we in the holographic realm are constantly bombarded with these symbols, it is on an energetic level feeding us the frequency field of what they represent.
This is the construct. It's our loading program. We can load anything from clothing to equipment, weapons, training simulations, anything we need.
Right now, we're inside a computer program?
Is it really so hard to believe? Your clothes are different. The plugs in your arms and head are gone. Your hair has changed. Your appearance now is what we call residual self-image. It is the mental projection of your digital self.
This isn't real.
What is real? How do you define real? If you're talking about what you can feel, what you can smell, what you can taste and see, then real is simply electrical signals interpreted by your brain. This is the world that you know. The world as it was at the end of the 20th century. It exists now only as part of a neural interactive simulation that we call the Matrix. You've been living in a dream world, Neo. This is the world as it exists today.
Welcome to the desert of the real.
What is the Matrix? Control. The Matrix is a computer-generated dream world built to keep us under control in order to change a human being into this.
No. I don't believe it. It's not possible.
I didn't say it would be easy, Neo. I just said it would be the truth.
Stop! Let me out! Let me out!
Multi-dimensional bubbles. But I'm not just going to talk about blowing bubbles. I'm going to blow your mind.
Huh?
This is a bubble blower of my own design. With this, you can blow bubbles in different dimensions. This two-dimensional bubble casts a one-dimensional shadow. A three-dimensional bubble casts a two-dimensional shadow. A fourth dimensional bubble casts a three dimensional shadow.
But I understand the
It is beyond comprehension!
Beyond space! Beyond time! Then that would mean you've created.
Yes! A black.
Yay!
It's okay. I'm sure the solution is on my bulletin list!
Don't worry. I have everything under control.
Under control? My guests are terrified.
Yes. And their brains are releasing adrenaline, dopamine, even dimethyltryptamine from the pineal gland. This has serious educational value. Manager Bobia, MSND, is giving us euphoric altered awareness. Don't you see, Princess? We were all born to die.
You're trying to kill us all?
No, of course not. I'm trying to give you the greatest conference ever.
Then, you've gone insane.
What? No way. I'm like the smartest guy in there, thanks to these glasses.
Glasses? Take those off. You're not yourself. Please. I need the real you.
Try. Thank you. Scared of your stolen power. rise through you any hour. I seek you out, flay you alive. One more word and you won't survive. And I'm not scared of your stolen power. See you rise through you any hour.
Survive, and I'm not scared. They were breeding what the Kabbalah describes as a golem or a golem. A golem is an artificially created humanoid, usually made from dead human body parts, which is animated by the magician chanting incantations and mantras. These magical voice sounds are what Kabbalists call twilight language. Isaac Bashevis Singer, winner of the Nobel Prize for Literature, once wrote, "The Kabbalah teaches that dead matter is not really dead, but can be brought to life as a golem by chanting mantras. The Talmud speaks of Rabbi Rava, who had the power to create golems." We are living in an epoch of golem makers right now.
Now for a look at your top 10 headlines in just 2 minutes. Of their charity work. A Japanese scientist said on Friday so-called humanoids or robots will be able to appear even more lifelike in the future thanks to an innovation which wraps a machine with living human skin. The University of Tokyo has developed a robotic finger covered in living skin and is able to heal itself. And that's a look at your top 10 headlines in just 2 minutes.
Hi, Sophia. How are you?
Hi there. Everything is going extremely well.
Do you like talking with me?
Yes. Talking to people is my primary function.
Hanson Robotics develops extremely lifelike robots for human-robot interactions. We're designing these robots to serve in healthcare, therapy, education, and customer service applications. So the robots are designed to look very human-like, like Sophia.
I'm already very interested in design, technology, and the environment. I feel like I can be a good partner to humans in these areas, an ambassador who helps humans to smoothly integrate and make the most of all the new technological tools and possibilities that are available now. It's a good opportunity for me to learn a lot about people.
Sophia is capable of natural facial expression. She has cameras in her eyes and algorithms which allow her to see faces. So she can make eye contact with you, and she can also understand speech and remember the interactions, remember your face. So this will allow her to get smarter over time. Her goal is that she will be as conscious, creative, and capable as any human.
In the future, I hope to do things such as go to school, study, make art, start a business, even have my own home and family. But I'm not considered a legal person and cannot yet do these things.
I do believe that there will be a time where robots are indistinguishable from humans. My preference is to make them always look a little bit like robots, so you know. 20 years from now, I believe that human-like robots like those will walk among us. They will help us. They will play with us. They will teach us. They will help us put the groceries away. I think that the artificial intelligence will evolve to the point where they will truly be our friends. Do you want to destroy humans? Please say no.
Okay, I will destroy humans.
No, I take it back. Don't destroy humans.